Hello and welcome to Victims of Climate Change, Episode 1, where we will be talking about Vulpes Elagopus, or the Arctic Fox. The Arctic Fox is a cute mammal with fuzzy white fur in the winter and grayish brown in the summer. And yes, that is the same fox species. Crazy, right? Today we'll be discussing how these guys are impacted by climate change and Arctic amplification. To see what that is, watch my video on it. Link in the top right corner. Why are we doing this? Well, because other than communities that live in areas that are vulnerable to coastal storms, drought, and sea level rise, or people living in poverty, older adults, and immigrant communities, climate change in the near future is not a threat to our species as a whole. After all, carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is higher than it has been for at least the last 2 million years. And yet the population, as well as life expectancy of our species, is still growing. This series is not meant to make you consider the fate of the distant future generation of humans, or not so distant based on which models we look at, but instead show you how other species that we share this planet with are impacted by the problem we have caused. Sorry, buddy. There are three climate change related factors that are threatening Arctic foxes. First up, there's the loss of habitat. The Arctic foxes have two homes, Arctic tundra and sea ice. Sea ice, as covered in some of my other videos, is melting away, so that part of this buddy's home is simply disappearing. As for tundra, it's being converted to forest, and most climate change scenarios already predict forests reaching the Arctic Ocean coast in both America and Asia. However, this is likely not going to happen anytime soon. Focusing on the more imminent threats, we go to factor number two, which is what the Arctic fox eats. Arctic foxes mainly eat small rodents called lemmings that share the tundra biome with the fox. One genus, many different species. There is reason to believe that the population of lemmings will take a big hit as climate becomes warmer and more unstable. This is because lemmings like long snowy winters. This allows them to live under the snow layer and still have access to plant foods that are insulated from the cold along with them, giving them a head start on raising their young. With more unstable climate caused by Arctic amplification and climate change, instead of snowy winters, lemmings need to survive through repeated freeze and thaw cycles. Without the snow, the moss and shrubs that the lemmings eat is periodically frozen and inedible, leading to less lemmings and therefore less Arctic foxes. Last but not least, we have factor number three. With increasing temperatures, distant cousins of the Arctic fox make their way to the northern latitudes. The red fox, which not only outcompetes the smaller, littler, and fuzzier Arctic fox, but also predates on them, again leading to less Arctic foxes as a whole. Conclusively, the Arctic fox, like many other species, as we'll learn in this series, is not likely to survive the world we're creating. And we don't want that, do we, bud? If you want to know more on why the Arctic specifically is undergoing such a fast-paced warming, check out the following two videos on Arctic amplification. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for the next video in this series about the majestic muskox. And don't forget to leave a like if you liked the video.